गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः रामाय रामभद्राय रामचन्द्राय वेदसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीताया पतये नमः सीताया पतये नमः सीताया पतये नमः आई थिंक लास्ट वीक वी डिड अप टिल 8 इजंट इट 13 तक किया है ओके ओके सो वील हाँ तो ठीक है वील कम टू द कलयुग एनी वे वी आर इन इट बट वॉट इज हर बार थोड़ा थोड़ा देखेंगे अभी फर्स्ट चैप्टर इन बालकांड ऑल्सो इट विल कम बट वेन वी टॉक अबाउट आध्यात्म रामायण इज अवर अटेंशन ऑन द स्टोरी इज अवर अटेंशन ऑन द कैरेक्टर्स is our attention on the situations that are arising because in some Ramayana it is told Jatayu takes Ramchandra ji to the sea in some Ramayana it is told that Hanuman ji found the way and he went then he came back and he told so different places which one are we supposed to believe there are different versions and which one is right which one is wrong We can't decide that because we have got that in our in our shastras. But this is a historical fact. But every master has written some fact. Because when you remember one thing, now from adhyatma point of view, what is adhyatma? Your essence. A saint or a sage who has realized his essential nature. What is this essential nature? यतो वाचो निवर्तन्ते अप्राप्य मनसासा मीन्स इट इज बियॉन्ड स्पीच एंड बियॉन्ड कॉम्प्रिहेंशन ऑफ माइंड सो ही हैज रियलाइज्ड राम आफ्टर दैट ही इज राइटिंग द स्टोरी ऑफ राम हाउ कैन ही डू द ट्रूथ टू दैट स्टोरी विच कैनॉट बी कैप्चर्ड बाय वर्ड्स विच कैनॉट बी कैप्चर्ड बाय आइडियाज एंड कंसेप्ट यू आर पुटिंग इट इन टू द एंड प्रेजेंटिंग इट टू द पीपल इट विल बी अ स्टोरी ऑफ each of that particular master because that master is established in truth but his mind is telling some leela in the way he has experienced it see so what should be our approach when we are coming to adhyatma ramayana our approach should be don't get lost in the events don't get lost why sita ji walked on the fire was it right or not right Why did Ramchandra ji make her go out of the kingdom by listening to one washerman? Our attention is not on that. That is just fillers, if we want to use. Our attention when we are studying Tulsi Adhyatma Ramayana is on the Adhyatma Tattva. Adhyatma Adi Tattva. Adi Tattva is that which is the most ancient, unborn. And tattva, the essence. And what is that essence? That essence is yours, mine, and the whole universe's. And when you come to that tattva and realize that he and you are not one, because there, you will not be there anyway to say that, to find that out. But when you look back, because you cannot stop expressing through the body, this is the phenomena. So once you have accessed and You have merged into the tattva, and then when you come back into the mind, because mind just like it goes into sleep and again it wakes up, what do you find when you wake up every morning? The same world as yesterday, isn't it? When you go into samadhi, your mind goes into samadhi. It's not that you go into, your mind goes into samadhi, nirvikalpa, but when it comes out, what does it find? The same world. Correct? When the mind gets absorbed into the tattva, द राम तत्व द द एक एक एकमेवा द्वितीय परब्रह्म परमात्मा एंड व्हेन इट कम्स आउट बिकॉज द नेचर ऑफ द माइंड इज टू गेट विड्रॉन एंड कम आउट अगेन सो व्हेन इट कम्स आउट व्हाट हैपेंस ही फाइंड्स द माइंड फाइंड्स दैट हे आई अलोन आई एम जीव जगत ईश्वर दैट जीव ऑल्सो दिस फिनोमिना ऑफ जीव ऑल्सो आई एम द फिनोमिना ऑफ ईश्वर ऑल्सो आई एम एंड द फिनोमिना ऑफ द वर्ल्ड ऑल्सो आई एम देर इज ऑल दीज थ्री is my bliss alone, my expansion alone. With this background, with this mindset, we approach Adhyatma Ramayana. So we are not here to condone anyone. We are not here to compare Tulsidas ji said this, or Valmiki ji said this, or Vedvyas ji said this, or Kamba said this, or so many different versions are there. We are not here to compare or prove what is right and wrong. Our purpose when we interact with Shastra, this is a Shastra. When we interact with Shastra, it is what is Shastra? It is an Astra. Astra hai na? Astra matlab it's a weapon. But for what? To cut. To cut what? Cut all that which is unnecessary. And what is unnecessary? That which is changing is unnecessary. So Shastra helps us, and especially this one, because it is titled Adhyatma. So when we interact with this Shastra, Adhyatma Ramayana, it is only for one purpose. You can enjoy the story, no doubt. But our purpose, clear purpose, will be that as we are studying the story or going through the text, our attention always is on the substratum. Our attention is always on the essence of all that there is. And with that, we'll start with the 13th verse again today. We are in the Adhyatma Ramayana Mahatmya. Tyaktasvajati karmanah प्रायश पंच परवंचवकाः क्षत्रियाश्च तथा वैश्याः स्वधर्मत्यागशीलिनः तद्वत् शूद्राश्च ये केचिद् ब्राह्मणाचार तत्पराः स्त्रियश्च प्रायशो भ्रष्टा भर्तृवज्ञान निर्भयाः सो last time we saw the Brahmins being eclipsed, overcome, subjugated by greed, avarice, would sell the Vedas and earn livelihood from it and acquire knowledge only to earn money and shall become haughty and arrogant due to their knowledge and superior birth. This till here we did last week. I'm not going to repeat anything. And now we are talking about the symptoms of Kali Yuga. So, first they told about the grahastha, then they talked about the Brahmins and the sannyasis, and then now the kshatriyas, the Brahmins, and now the kshatriyas and the vaishyas. The kshatriyas and vaishyas, that is the warriors and the trading class, they would also abandon their role in the society, their duties and responsibilities, and instead become deceitful. They will manipulate, they will be corrupt, and they will cheat, and they will be full of deceit. Greed takes over, and when greed takes over, all these things start. Tadvat shudrashchaye, and what about the shudras? Similarly, shudras, the low caste, would indulge in Brahmin-like behaviors, while the woman would be generally unchaste, disloyal, and would not shy from insulting their husbands. So, it's both ways. If the husband is insulting the wife or wife is insulting the husband, that is not the way of the Brahmins. Why? What is the way of the Brahmin? Culture, moral, etiquettes. Whereas, what is the standard of the Shudras? Because how do we decide what is Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra? Gyan and Karma. So, if you have the Gyan, if the Shudra is having the Gyan, of all the culture, but is behaving totally opposite, diametrically opposite to it, then he is not a Brahmin. That's what here it is being told. And in this manner, continuing, श्वशुरद्रोहकारिण्यो भविष्यन्ति न संशयः एतेषां नष्टबुद्धीनां परलोक कथं भवेत् इति चिन्ताकुलं चित्तं जायते मम संततं लघुपायेन येनैषां परलोकगतिर्भवेत् तमुपायमुपाख्याहि सर्वं वेत्ति यतो भवान्. There is no doubt that they would be malicious towards the father and mother-in-laws. All serials are talking that only. Huh? How is it possible to have their emancipation and salvation? And then this is a cause of constant worry for me. Tell me, this is Naraji saying, huh? Tell me a simple method, way by which one can redeem themselves, because you are all-knowing. Narad Muniji approached Brahmaji. Why did he approach? Here it was told, out of concern for the world. Sadhus are always concerned about the world. Sadhus are not going, if they go to someone's house, we see in some serials also, and you read it in their biographies also, when they go to someone's house for food, they will get one chapati or something for bhiksha. They eat very less without taxing that family. But the blessings that they give is much, much, much more. Unseen blessings by the people receiving it. But in his heart, it's only love and blessings for the family. And same way, Narad Muniji, he is the greatest one. He is the all-knowing one. He has direct entry into Vaikuntha also. So when he goes to Brahmaji, seeing the time that is coming in the future, which is Kali Yuga, he goes out of concern. Is there no way for salvation for such people with Shudra Buddhi? Because Kali Yuga is predominantly Shudra Buddhi. Democracy is Shudra Buddhi. Democracy is not cultured Buddhi. It is Shudra Buddhi. Because majority are fools at the moment. So fools selecting a... You can decide. So he says, is there a simple way by which these people, all the people in Kali Yuga, can attain salvation? Question to this answer can be only given by you, because you are all knowing. Oh, because he was, Naraji is the mind born son of Brahmaji, isn't it? And in this manner, continuing, we'll read 17 and 18. Ityrusher vakyamakarnya pratyuvachambujasanaha sadhu prushtam tvaya sadho vakshetat shrunu sadaram pura tripura hantaram parvati bhaktavatsala Shri Rama Tattvam Jignyasuhu Papracha Vinayanvita Priyayai Girishastasyai Gudham Vyakhyata Vansvayam. Bas utna hi. Ityarshe Vakyam Akarnya. Akarnya, to listen. Having heard these words from the celestial sage, our Narad Muniji, Pratyuvacha Mujasanaha, who heard? Brahmaji, who is sitting on the lotus. Ambuja, lotus. Asana, you understand asana. Sadhu prushtam tvaya sadho vakshe tat shrunu sadaram. He replied, he says, you have asked a wonderful question. You have asked a wonderful thing. And it is not something that you have asked for yourself. It is for the whole universe. And therefore you asked a good thing. I shall tell you, sadho vakshe tat shunu sadaram, listen attentively, listen with respect, listen with availability, sa adaram, with respect, with reverence you listen to it, not because I am saying it. See, when our Swamiji also keeps saying, now listen, be attentive, it's not that he wants you to be attentive to him, but it's the words which are coming out. If it is only going to benefit the person who is attentive, the teacher, the master, the God, he is always speaking. He will always communicate. But are we available? He is available right now also. Then why are we not available to the God right now? He is present, fully present here also. Then why are we not available? Somewhere some shortcoming is there, no? Some error we are practicing in our life, which is keeping us away from our essence. So therefore, when Brahmaji is saying, he's not saying it out of ego, now listen to me because I'm all knowing. No. He is all knowing, that is a foregone fact. That is his nature. And so is yours. So is a sadhu's who has perfected himself. So when Brahmaji says, Sa Adara, with reverence and respect, listen, because these words are potent. They are coming from such a master, here Brahmaji, or in cases of saints and sages, when we listen, the words do not come from the person. The words come by the will of the divine. Vyas Peeth is not a seat from where the ego expresses. The teacher must be surrendered to the divine and become empty, so the divine can express through him in whatever way. And therefore, when it says, I shall tell you, Tachunu Sadaram Sa Adaram Pura Tripura Hantaram Parvati Bhakta Vatsala Pura Tripura Hantaram, in the ancient times, in the earlier times, Parvati ji, who is she? She is the consort of Lord Shiva. And Tripura Hantaram Parvati Bhakta Vatsala. Bhakta Vatsala, she loves her devotees. All the Bhakta is devotee. Vatsala, she considers them to be her children. Vatsala. That Vatsalya Bhav only a mother can experience. True, the Vatsalya is again from Vatsala is a cow. So from the Vatsalya, the cow, mother cow, the love that she shows towards a newborn calf, that is Vatsalya. Same we see with every mother and child. So Bhakta Vatsala, Vatsala is coming from there. And he says that who loves her devotees and who was inspired, Shri Rama Tattvam Jignyasuhu. See, Rama Tattvam Jignyasu, who was very interested, who was inspired, who was motivated to know the secret, the secret of the Supreme Essence. And what is the Supreme Essence? It is the Absolute Truth. It is that Ekameva Dvitiya Paramatma. That is what Paprachya Vinayanvita. She Priyayai Girishastasyai Gudham Vyakhyata Van Swayam. About Ram, and asked, and therefore she asked Lord Shiva, who is the destroyer of Tripura? Remember, Pura Tripura Hantaram. Hantaram is to kill. Tripurari, so he has destroyed the Tripuri. What is the Tripuri? Tell someone. That is in the story, Adhyatma. Good. It is Jagrat Avastha, Swapna Avastha and Nidra Avastha. Waking plane of consciousness, dream plane of consciousness and deep sleep plane of consciousness. In other words, Tripuri, Sattva Rajastamas. This is the world, whole world has come out of Sattva Rajastamas. When consciousness expresses through Sattva, it is called Waker. When it expresses through Rajas, it is dreamer. When it is expressing through Tamas, it is called Sushupti. He who has Hantaram killed, here killed means not to khatak nikal the gardan. Over, they will continue to express. You are not affected by them. You are not caught up by them. You are not entangled in them. You have recognized that you are other than these three. For example, you are all Tripurari. You are all Tripura Hantaram. Why? You No, you are a man in spite of being a husband, a son, and a father. Tripuri, Tripurahantaram. So if under all conditions, even when wife is in front of you, you let the mind express as husband, but you remain the witness of what is going on, then you are a Tripurahantaram. So when you play all the roles in life, but are not affected by the roles, you don't become serious about the roles, but you do the roles correctly, joyfully, like Krishna used to do. Tripurahantaram, that is Lord Shiva. And so is also Lord Krishna, so is also Narayana. So he who is the destroyer of the most powerful. So she asked this question to Lord Shiva, her husband, that, so here purposely these words are used. She could say, oh, Parvati asked the question, wanting to know who is Ram, the absolute truth, to her husband Shiva. If she asked the husband, husband can never come to be the Tripurahantaram. Husband can never come to know Ram. He can't. Only he who is beyond being a husband. So that significance is there. That she, so if she asks the husband, he will say, acha yaar, if he says, what was that? Tat shrunu sadaram. Suppose Shivji told her, tat shrunu sadaram, listen with respect and reverence. Acha, jada bolte ho? Chalo, phatafat mereko batao, ek line mein batao, mere paas jada time nahi hai. Then it is not, then she is not addressing the teacher. Here she wants knowledge. She wants to know the supreme truth. It requires a special condition of mind. It requires, if you are asking, you are a student, and the one to whom you are asking is the teacher. And your respect and reverence toward the teacher is, my teacher, this teacher of mine, whether it is a husband, whether it is a father, whether it is a mother, whether it is a human or a god, knows the truth. With that faith you are going to him, with that surrender you are going to him, with that availability you are going to him, then the knowledge will, you will be able to receive the knowledge. Otherwise, where is the question? You will not receive the knowledge otherwise. Because you are seeing, Are ye to mera pat, this is my husband, what is, chalo, let me keep him busy, he keeps meditating all the time, acha, tell me who is Ram. Chalo, over the dinner we'll discuss. Because I'm Annapurna. Over the desert we'll have the discussion around. Like this, it doesn't, the knowledge doesn't come. We have to be, this is the fine tuning that is required if we want knowledge. Continuing. Puranottam adhyatma रामायणम् इति स्मृतं तत्पार्वती जगद्धात्री पूजयित्वा दिवानिशम् आलोचयन्ति स्वानन्दं स्वानन्द मग्ना तिष्ठति साम्प्रतम्. हाँ ठीक है, 20 तक हो गया ना. सो द पुराण उत्तम अध्यात्म रामायणम् इति स्मृतम्. एक लाइन में बता दिए पूरा. सो व्हाट, हाउ डिड वी बिगिन दिस क्लास टुडे, दैट व्हाट इज अध्यात्म. सो द सीक्रेट दैट महादेव जी इज गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब और नरेट टू पार्वती जी एट और एक्सप्लेन टू पार्वती जी एट दैट टाइम केम टू बी नोन एज अध्यात्म रामायण एंड रामायणम इति स्मृतम. ही रिमेम्बर्ड. How do I communicate to her who is Ram? How do I communicate to her? He is that. Tattvamasi bol diya. Yeah. Aise thoda na hota hai. To usko to samajhna hai. Shakti is always chanchal. Shakti is always chanchal, like our mind is chanchal. It need, she has come. Now he has to engage that mind for some time so that it can sink into that mind. So like when we come to the satsang, we are here for 2 hours, hopefully we are able to engage your mind for 2 hours so that something in the 2 hours goes and settles deeply in your heart and mind. And that's automatically that transformation comes about then. We don't have to do anything to transform. All you have to do is be available. And sometimes when we keep saying the same thing again and again, someday maybe out of frustration you say, chal yaar maan liya, ab usi samay ho jayega sab kuch. And at other times you are available, sometimes it's through bhajan, sometimes it's through satsang. But satsang is where jnan is, knowledge is there. Everything must lead to knowledge. And knowledge about whom? Knowledge about that absolute, that supreme, who is expressing through your heart and mind. Who is you? See? So that came to be known as a Ramayana. And Tat Parvati Jagat Dhatri Puja Yitva Devanisham. So now the mother of mother Parvati, the mother of whole creation, the mother of all the Bhaktavatsalas, she mother of all creation, she worships it, thinks and contemplates. Alochayanti Swananda Magna Tishthati Sampratam. Magna, magna matlab kya hote hain? Rati, rat ho jana, magna ho jana, jaise jab hum Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. If we continue for some time, so your mind goes into a lull. You are awake and your mind is chanting, no effort is there. That is magna. You are intoxicated. You are single-pointedly intoxicated but without going to sleep. Then it is magna. You are totally indulgent but without a desire. It's a conundrum, contradiction. You are totally involved but without a desire. That is magna. So he says that she started worshipping the Adhyatma. She worships the Adhyatma Ramayana. She thinks about the Adhyatma Ramayana and she contemplates on the Adhyatma Ramayana and on it day and night, and remains submerged in the state of a Swananda. Sva Ananda. And what is the, whatever is the theme of Adhyatma Ramayana, Adhyatma Ramayana theme is not the story, it is Ram. And Sva Ananda, she takes Ramchandra ji as the Sva, the Atma. And in that bliss, she is revealing who? Parvati ji. In other words, you want to take it at your personal, as a subjective, our mind. Shiv and Parvati, eternal witness, the witnessing consciousness, Atma, and Parvati, our mind. So let our mind continuously remain engaged, think, contemplate, and come to experience that my source, our mind I'm talking about, that the source of mine, with all the thoughts that are coming right now, is that Ram. That I am in essence. This is surrender. And tishthati sampratam, and she remains there. Continuing. See, I'm not going too deep into it because all these points will be later on in the whole Adhyatma Ramayana is only Vedanta. So you will enjoy along with the story though. And they are unfolding the stories, each one how it is. 21 and 22. Pracharishyati talloke pranadrushtavashadhyada tasyadhyayana matrena जनायास्यन्ति सद्गतिं तावद् विजृम्भते पापं ब्रह्महत्या पुरःसरं यावद् जगति नाध्यात्म रामायणमुदेश्यति। लॉर्ड शिवा इज टेलिंग हर दैट एट प्रचरिष्यति प्रचरिष्यति तल्लोके when this Radhyatma Ramayana at the appropriate time, in the right time, when it becomes available to, it becomes renowned in the whole world, at that time, when it is propagated in the whole world, and why it is propagated, is it because of someone? No, because of Ishwar Kripa, because of his will, not because of someone's wish. Tulsidasji never says, I wrote a Tulsi Ramayana. No, he says, Lord Shiva used to come and write. He only protects, he only inspired, he only did everything. Lord Goswami Tulsidas, his entire Ramayana, Tulsi Ramayana, his motivation came from Adhyatma Ramayana. It did not come from Valmiki Ramayana. Here also, the dialogue begins with Parvati and Shivji. There also, it begins with Shivji and Parvati. See?
This doesn't happen in Valmiki Ramayana.
No. Valmiki Ramayana is factual. He writes down all the events as they are happening. Or, because he was present in those times, so he saw it all happening, so he noted down all those. So it's a historical fact. So propagated in the world due to the advent, due to by chance or by grace of the divine, and not only by the grace of the divine, but also grace of the divine is always present. But the right circumstances should present. Under right circumstances, you get a heart attack. Under right circumstances, a Tulsidas becomes Goswami Tulsidas. Under right circumstances, Ratnakar Daku becomes Valmiki. Similarly, the grace is all the time, but under the right circumstances, the masala sahi padna chahiye sara, then it becomes available to everyone. People get inspired to engage with it, and to whom? Not just to the world, but to the people. It is not telling, Ramayana is not for walls and bricks. It is for human beings. So each human being, when right circumstances come about by the grace of the divine, Adhyatma Ramayana comes into our life. See how wonderful. They would get when human beings engage with Adhyatma Ramayana, they will come to a auspicious end in their life. That is, and what is that auspicious end? That I will die in sleep, is that the auspicious end? Or I will get a stroke or a heart attack and I won't know that I died, is that an auspicious end? No, auspicious end is salvation. Auspicious end is merging into the divine while living, and that is possible through Adhyatma Ramayana when we engage with it by being available to it. Or for devotees, if you want to look at it from the relative, that the soul will merge into the divine. That is the goal. That is possible in this lifetime. Because not everyone is looking at Parabrahma Paramatma, who is Nirgun Nirakar. Some of them are looking at him as Ram. If they want to go to Saket, let them go to Saket. As long as we consider ourselves to be a soul, as a body, nothing can happen. If you consider yourself as a jiva, then there is a possibility, two possibilities. Either you merge into the Lord, or you merge into the Parabrahma Paramatma. Both into the Ishvara or into the Parabrahma Paramatma. Both is the one and the same thing. And in this way, and as a result, here he says, तस्याश्च नम अध्ययन मात्रेण जना यास्यन्ति तद्गतिम्। व्हाट इज सद्गतिम्? सद्गति इज इमेंसिपेशन, सेल्वेशन। एंड देन तावत् विजृंभते पापम्। दिस होल वर्ल्ड विच इज कंटिन्यूअसली योनिंग एंड इज फुल ऑफ पाप, इज फुल ऑफ एरर्स, इज फुल ऑफ डिजायर्स, इज फुल ऑफ व्हाट यू कॉल आइडेंटिफिकेशन, वी बिकम फ्री ऑफ ऑल दैट। विजृंभते पापम ब्रह्म हत्या पुरसरम। एंड नॉट ओनली दैट, दैट वन बिकम्स फ्री ऑफ द ब्रह्म हत्या। इफ नोइंगली अनोइंगली वी हैव किल्ड सम कल्चर्ड पर्सन, एजुकेटेड पर्सन, नॉलेजेबल पर्सन, नॉलेजेबल पर्सन हु इज प्रैक्टिसिंग दैट नॉलेज इन देयर लाइफ इज कॉल्ड अ ब्राह्मिन। इफ बाय मिस्टेक वी हैव बीन इंस्ट्रूमेंटल इन दैट पर्सन्स डेथ by mistake, accident or knowingly, we can atone for it by studying Brahmahatya. When will you be able to? What is the requirement? As long as you are identified with body, you think that everyone is separate. Simple answer for Brahmahatya atonement. Pata nahi pichle janam mein kiyo, uske pehle kiyo, we don't know. Dronacharya was a Brahmin. He was killed by Arjuna. It's a Brahmahatya. See? So how do we atone? The only way to atone for all sins that we have committed in this world is by coming to know you are that one who alone is expressing as the whole world. तो तुम अपने आप को क्या पाप कर सकते हो? कर ही नहीं सकते अपने ऊपर पाप, बिकॉज यू आर एवरीथिंग, देर इज नो अदर, देर इज नो डुअलिटी देन। तो दैट इज एनीवे, आई एम गोइंग अहेड। सो सच सिंस सच एज द किलिंग ऑफ ब्राह्मिन्स एक्सेट्रा वुड एग्जिस्ट ओनली टिल द टाइम दैट आध्यात्म रामायण डज नॉट मेक इट्स एंट्री इन टू दिस वर्ल्ड। सो वंस वर्ल्ड मीनिंग, नाउ डोंट थिंक वर्ल्ड इज दिस वर्ल्ड। What is your world? We are talking subjectively. What is your world? Waking, dream, deep sleep. That is your world. Where is it? Where is the deep sleep world? In your mind. Where is the dream world? In your mind. Where is the waking world? Also in your mind, but because of your error of identification with this body, you think the world is outside. समझ गए? सुरेश इज रिमेम्बरिंग हिज चार्ट इन हिज ऑफिस। सो व्हेन सो द मोमेंट आध्यात्म रामायण एंटर्स इन अवर वर्ल्ड, मीनिंग इन टू अवर माइंड, एंड वी स्टार्ट एंगेजिंग विद इट, ऑल स्मॉल स्मॉल एरर्स और बिग एरर्स लाइक ब्रह्महत्या, they will all become neutralized. This is the phala of studying Adhyatma Ramayana, continuing in the 23rd and 24th verse. Tavat kalima hotsaho nishankam sampravartate yavat jagatin adhyatma ramayana mudeshyati tavadyama bhatapshuraha संचरिष्यन्ति निर्भयाः यावत् जगति नाध्यात्म रामायणमुदेश्यति। कलयुग विल हैव इट्स फ्री रन ओनली टिल द टाइम आध्यात्म रामायण डज नॉट राइज इन दिस वर्ल्ड। राइज मीन्स मेक्स इट्सेल्फ प्रेजेंट इन दिस वर्ल्ड, बिकम्स अवेलेबल टू पीपल इन दिस वर्ल्ड। सो टिल देन कलयुग इज गोइंग अप एंड अप। नाउ if you just want to take that word and look at it, the last 1200 years have been the worst on the planet. Worst slavery and colonization and this and that and everything, but now today the amount of knowledge that is spreading all around the world, it's much more than any time Every person has access to knowledge if they choose to, because Google is free to everyone. So knowledge is available. According to the modern science, you know, the what do you call these new age people? The new age people say all knowledge is in the Akashic records, and we also, our scripture is already saying it. All knowledge is in Avyakta. Avyakta is what? Space, unmanifest. Unmanifest is space. In the space which is unmanifest, all knowledge is already present. Remember, towards the end of Srimad Bhagavat, what did Brahmaji contemplate upon when he came out of the navel of Lord Vishnu? There was nothing. So he started listening to silence. What is the sound of silence? When he became without fear, when he kept becoming available to it, the unmanifest sound, the silence, appeared to him as Om. That is how it was told there. And once you have the, once you become available to that silence, then it is Om, then it is the vowels and consonants, then they are the sutras, then what are Vedas and Vedas? They are Shruti Granthas. Shruti Granthas, all those saints and sages who meditated on the Akash Tattva or the Om Tattva, the source of the creation, or on the silence, to them, whatever, with whatever intention, the knowledge was revealed to them. That is called Shruti. They heard it. Heard it not by their, they may have heard it by their ears, or their mind must have heard it. Just like I know one girl, she was, she's still there. She used to live in a hostel, and she was devoted to Swami Tejomenanji. For him, for her, she is God, he is God, and he is the Guru. And every night she will go to her hostel, she'll go to sleep on the floor, but the bed is for imaginary Swamiji. For us, imaginary, for him it is real. She feels that there is Swamiji sleeping there. She'll give him water, she will wake him up, she'll press his feet, she'll put the blanket on him, then take it out, and then all that she does. And while we were studying, she had been with him for quite some time. With him means she used to come every day to the ashram. And one day she came, she didn't tell everyone, because people, you know how youngsters are, they will take the mickey out of you. So she came and told me. She said, Brahmachari, I want to tell you something. I said, what? Because I had asked her to bring me a Sai Baba photograph for me. So she brought that, and then she told me, because you are accepting it, others say Sai Baba is a fake and this and that, I'll tell you something. I said, what? She says, every night I do this, and lately I am getting all these mantras in my mind, and compositions are coming. So I said, what did you do? Why don't you write down? She says, yeah, 2 weeks ago they started coming, and now I'm keeping a note and pen at night next to my bed on the floor, and whenever they come, I'm awake that time, but I'm seeing that these compositions are coming, I just start writing down. And she showed it to Swami. Swamiji was so happy. Shruti. She has never studied Sanskrit. She has never studied Sanskrit. She has not studied composition of bhajans or shlokas. Anushtup Chanda she doesn't know. But revelation comes from within. This can happen to anyone, because she is so devoted. She wants, it must have, some urge must have been there. It came. Who are we to decide how Lord wants to express? That devotion came out in that particular way. So here, so until and unless Adhyatma Ramayana, meaning, what is Adhyatma Ramayana? Not the book. The Ram doesn't come until Ram, the moment Ram comes and reveals himself in our heart, that very moment all the papas, all the sins become neutralized, and only till then Kali Yuga will have effect on us. Because if we are Dharana, Dhyan, Samadhi also, on Ram Tattva. If you are doing it, body identification is not there. Mind is merging into the Ram Tattva. So where are the problems? In the body. Where are the shortcomings? In the mind, on account of the body. And because I think the mind thinks it is the body, so the world is there. So now mind is completely absorbed in Ram, 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 Ram. No availability to the world, no availability to the body. Where's the sin? All neutralized. Where's the sin when we go to sleep every night? Not available. You don't commit any sin while sleeping. So when we are absorbed, magna, what's that? Magna. When we are engrossed, magna is engrossed. When we are engrossed in the adhyatma, that is Ram in our heart, with bhav, with single-pointedness, ananyash chintayanto mam, exclusive to everything else, we approach him in our heart, then nothing in this world can touch us. Nothing can touch us. Yavat jagatin adhyatma ramayanam udeshyati. The brave and ferocious messengers of Yam, god of death and hell, would roam freely, unhindered and unopposed in this world only till the time this Adhyatma Ramayana does not manifest itself. Who is Yama? Yama is the lord of death, Yamaraj. Who are his dutas? His dutas means his messengers. They are messengers of death. They are searching. Who is ready to die? Chalo, we have to take that soul. Then we'll decide whether he goes to heaven or hell. पर वो यमराज को देख के ही छुट्टी हो जाती है. Those who fertile imagination, no human beings, or why human beings? Mind. So when we are totally engrossed in the Ram Naam, the Ram Tattva in our heart and mind, meaning we have. Even though body is there, but we are not the body. Even though the jiva is there, but jiva hood is not there, because you are so engrossed in the Ram Naam that you have lost the sense of being an individual also. At that time, the messengers of death of Lord Yamaraj, they do not have jurisdiction over you. They do not have. Same story came in Srimad Bhagavat, where Ajamil, who was sleeping, and when he is getting old and he is dying, he chants Narayan, he calls out his son, the youngest son. But that time, because he has committed so many sins, even though he was a Brahmin, the Yamadutas come, the messengers of death come. But because he called Narayan, the Vishnu Dutas also come, Narayana Dutas. And the moment the Narayan Dutas are like light in front of light, darkness, the Yama Dutas, they have got no stand. Hey, what is this? Where is this light coming from? And they start arguing, who are you? Where are you coming from? Why? They said, oh, he called our boss. No, but he has committed so sins. It is our property, not yours. So they said, no, we will not do anything. You go and talk to your boss. That means Yamaraj, lord of death, consult him. And see, tell him that he took the name of Lord Narayana, but he did not mean it, but he took it. So do we bring him here, or we leave him for Vishnu Dutas to take him? Yes. He says, what, Vishnu Dutas? Don't even go back. Don't even go back. And this Ajamil, who was first afraid of seeing the messengers of death, Yamdutas, then he saw the Vishnu Dutas, and he's lying there, he's listening to the discussion between them. Then he's waiting, now Yamadutas will come, but they don't come. Then Vishnu Dutas say, you got a second chance, my friend, because you took the name Narayana from your heart, even though it was for your son, but it is the name of the Lord. So now death is going to come, but this is not the time. Now you got a leeway, you got extra time. So correct your actions if you want entry into Vaikuntha. Same thing with here. Same thing here. If we bring Ram into our heart, I'm explaining, because it's Adhyatma, I'm explaining in this way. That because our heart and our mind is not available to the body, as a result of body, to the world, to the senses and to the world, then, or even to the soul, to the jiva, there's no sin. The Yamadutas have got no jurisdiction, no authority. Such a person is called, he has reached Sadgati. Then he is free from the cycle of birth and death. Such a person doesn't even want heaven. How beautiful. Just few, sometimes you look at it in a different way. I never explained in this manner when the Ajamil story came. I know what I told that time. But same thing is coming here, but a totally different approach. Maybe I have matured over 14 years. Now 25th and 26th verse. Tavat sarvani hai na? 20. Tavat sarvani shastrani vivadante parasparam tavat swarupam ramasya durbodham mahatamapi yavat jagatinadhyatma ramayana mudheshyati. We'll stop here. And all the discords, disputes and debates, confusions, contradictions among the scriptures, if you read Upanishads, there are contradictions. You read Bhagavad Gita, there are contradictions. Till today, maybe there is a contradiction in you. Do we do something and realize God, or God is realized by nishkam karma, akamya karma, that without any desire Lord is, or with desire you merge into Lord? Which one? I'm just teaser hai ye. Which one? Do I put efforts, or is the Paramatma, or is the Divine effortlessly gained? No, you discuss afterwards. Over dinner we'll discuss. So I'm just presenting the contradiction, that there are different mindsets. Some want to do it through Tantra, some want to do it through Kundalini, some want to do it through Hatha Yoga, some want to do it Kriya Yoga. All efforts, no? You are sitting here with efforts, knee is hurting, still effort. But back, upar baitho na yaar. So effort. So is Adhyatma, is the Divine attained through efforts, or is he effortless? Now this argument is going on between different philosophies. Are we here to prove who is right and wrong? Are we here to see if the glass is half full or half empty? Apne ko doodh peene se matlab hai yaar, tum aadha do ya pura do, humko usse koi matlab hi nahi. You take the nectar and be happy. But people are interested in discussing at what age did Sita get married? Who cares, yaar? It is given. But in different dramas, it's different. अब हम क्या, उससे हम, हमारा क्या फायदा है? हमारा क्या है? Just like, understand one thing. This you have to sort out. Just like every one of us, intrinsically from inside, we have a taste. We want to indulge. We have a calling to fill ourselves with food, to eat. Hunger comes. You don't create hunger, it comes. You don't create thirst, it happens. Similarly, this adhyatmic quest, the urge, your soul, your atma, we'll take the word soul here, the soul is looking for completion. The soul is looking for settlement. It wants to balance the sheet, man, enough. And from somewhere from inside, that urge is there in everyone. And that brings us to this Adhyatma Ramayana or to the Upanishads or to wherever. So if you are find some other people are also having that, but they choose to quieten their mind through drugs, through alcohol, to vegetate on cereals. See, there are different ways. Some people will go and they will have an adrenaline rush by climbing mountain after mountain after mountain, because it calms their mind. People do different things. If it brings knowledge, fantastic. You don't need to study anything in order to gain knowledge. Ramana Maharishi did not study anything to gain knowledge. He contemplated on his source. He was very focused. But are we? So I'm not here to discuss that. My point here is that it is intrinsic. It is from within, this urge to be complete. So we complete ourselves by food. We complete ourselves by relationships. We complete ourselves by social networks. We complete ourselves by identifying with this body, thinking this body will complete me. And you can keep adding so many things. But now you are grown up. Till now, has identifying with body been able to complete the urge in the soul to be complete? Has it completed? No. Then if you keep doing what you have been doing, you will keep getting incompletion. So we need to change tactic now. We need to change our approach. And that approach is, even while we are in satsang, satsang is good, fantastic. But in satsang, instead of enjoying satsang, let's be subjective. Because enjoying mein kya ho jata hai? We listen and we forget. We are not, but, and let that happen. But while you are listening, be completely available to yourself. And that's all that is required. So here he says, and all the discords, disputes, arguments, debates, discussions among the scriptures and the contradiction in the scriptures, as well as the ignorance about the true essence of nature, of Ram in mind and heart and intellect of great souls, would exist only till the time the light of Adhyatma Ramayana does not shine in this world. So all the loose ends are only as long as you are focused outwards. When we come to Adhyatma Ramayana or to Ram in our heart, everything starts getting unified. Everything starts getting coming to be the one who is supporting all, but not losing the oneness. Dekho, kya sundar baat hai. And that you are. Just like the woman supports all the roles, but because roles are appearing and disappearing, woman is not appearing and disappearing. Woman remains the same. The eyes, the vision remains the same. All the colors and forms come and go. Eyes are not affected by colors and forms. They are illuminating all the colors and forms, but I don't remain affected. Same way, mind is not affected by thoughts. Thoughts come and go. Keep going, come and going. Mind is the same. When you get identified with one thought, then problem begins. But what is the nature of the mind? To allow thoughts to appear and disappear, to manifest and unmanifest. That is mind. Similarly, then who are you? You are that principle who allows waking dream sleep, along with the waking world dream world sleep, absence of them, to come and go, but you remain unaffected. Adhyatma mein pahunch gaye, Ram ke paas pahunch gaye. And if it is too dry, then take Ram Nam. With this understanding, you take Ram Nam. Ki Ram is my essence. Not Ram who killed this, who killed that, he will kill. If you keep thinking about Ramana, Kumkarna, Vibhishana, and Hanuman, and this and that, then you are moving away from the essence. Your focus, you are interested in all the spices. You are not attentive on the one that is most important, that is Ram. Or if you come to know Ram, everything automatically will come to your understanding. But if your attention is on everything else, and through everyone else you want to come to know Ram, it will never be possible. Finite number of infinite experience of happiness is not equal to infinite happiness. Infinite times finite experiences of joy, which is only possible through objects, relationships, etc., etc., imaginations, concepts, is not equal to infinite happiness. Exactly the same thing. So come to recognize this, that Ram is the one. And we will, when we enter into the first chapter, you will be surprised what Sita says. I already told you last class. I will not tell it now again. Thoda to tum bhi wait karo. Verse 27 and 28. Adhyatma Ramayana Sankirtana Shravanadijam Phalam Vaktum Nashaknomi Karsnyena Munisattama Tathapitasya Mahatmyam Vakshe Kinchitavanagha Shrunuchittam Samadhaya Shive Noktam Puramama. Oh, the most exalted sage Narada, I cannot fully describe the benefits and rewards, that is fruits, phala. Phalam Vaktum Nashaknomi. It is not possible to tell me the fruit of listening to and singing the Adhyatma Ramayana. Karsneena Muni Sattama. Then Tathapi Tasya Mahatmyam Vakshe Kinchit Tavanagha. And but oh Anagha, Vanagha, oh Anagha, sinless one, pure one, faultless one, still I shall tell you a little, I'll tell you a little fraction of its glories. I'll tell you a little bit of its importance, because I cannot do justice to the whole thing. Earlier, Shiva had, here he says, Shunu Chittam Samadhaya, Shivena Uktam Pura Mama. Shivena Uktam Pura Mama, Pura in the earlier times, Mama, me, Shivena Uktam. Lord Shiva had told me in the previous time. And Shunu Chittam Samadhaya, Samadhaya, with an equanimous mind, with a calm mind, with a happy mind, with a peaceful mind, Shunu. Chittam is mind. Shunu, listen, O sage. Dekho kitna sundar, super, just bolte bolte mere ko maja aa raha hai. Aise bolte hain, so listen attentively, listen with samadhaya, with attention, with savdhan, with alertness, with vigilance. Continuing 29 and 30th. Adhyatma Ramayanatah Shlokam Shlokardham Evava Yappathet Bhakti Sanyuktah Sapapan Muchyate Kshanat Yasturvatyaham Adhyatma Ramayanam Ananyadhihi Yathashakti Vadet Bhaktya Sajivan Mukta Uchyate. Those Adhyatma Ramayanatah Shlokam Shlokardham Evava. Those who read one or even half of any shloka of this Adhyatma Ramayana with faith, with belief, with surrender, with sincerity, they are instantly freed. Yap patet bhakti sanyukta sa papan muchyate kshanat. Kshanat, verily, instantaneously, they are freed of all the sins, provided, what is the prerequisite? Shraddha, with bhakti, with devotion, with surrender. They said the same thing in Srimad Bhagavat also. We are still here. One more opportunity to surrender, to fine-tune ourselves. Then, yastu pratyaham adhyatma ramayanam ananyadhihi and yathashakti veda bhaktya sa jivan mukta uchyate. Those who listen to this adhyatma ramayana depending upon their ability and circumstances, ananyadhihi, according to their availability of their mind, are deemed yathashakti veda bhaktya, and they will be liberated from the shackles of this worldly existence by this cyclical birth and death, from this mundane existence. They'll be delivered from this hypnosis, from this matrix of life. Our problem is we believe we are the mind. What is the difference between me and us and Ishwara? Ishwara believes what? That he is the master of the mind. What is the mind there? His potentiality. And what is the potentiality for Ishwara? Unmanifest. Means he is in silence. Mind is silent. And if mind does become active, means starts manifesting, Ishwara is not disturbed. He maintains his silence. He allows the Shakti to go through, because Shakti's nature, mind's nature, Avyakta's nature is chanchal. It is, and what is that chanchalta? What is that flux? Manifestation and manifestation, manifestation and manifestation. Is it not your knowledge also? Manifestation, waking and dream, unmanifestation, deep sleep. Don't you know the thoughts manifest and then thoughts unmanifest? Every moment it is happening. When my eyes are open, world is manifest. When my eyes blink, world is unmanifest. That is the nature of the senses are part of the body. Body is only a thought in the mind. And mind's nature is flux. Involvement, withdrawal. Involvement, withdrawal. Don't you know it? Yes. Then who are you? The one who is involved and who is withdrawing, or the one who knows the process of withdrawal and involvement? Withdrawal and involvement. You are the one who know the two. Come to be that under all sets of circumstances. Under all sets of circumstances. Then alone, by the grace of Ram, nothing will be able to touch us. Find out somewhere, the urge is there, that's why you are here. The urge is there, that's why you all are listening. It has to be well directed. You have the urge, and therefore you know how to be effortlessly single-pointed. How do you become effortlessly single-pointed? First you put efforts on sleep, then you become effortless. Till you don't become effortless, your mind will not be absorbed into sleep. If you keep trying to sleep, you will not be able to sleep. You have to become effortless in order to be absorbed into sleep. Take now Ram Nam with efforts, understand, and at the same time you are listening every week, but rest of the time Ram 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 Ram, Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram, Sita Ram Bolo Sita Ram, kuch bhi bolo, but do it with faith, do it with this disposition that it is my soul, that it is me, that it is the one who is expressing as life through this body. I have no identity apart from this name that I am taking, who represents that infinite. And absorb yourself so you know. In sleep, you know how to dissolve your mind, to allow, you allow the mind to be sucked into sleep. Why don't you allow your mind to be sucked into Ram? What is stopping you? Not enough efforts, not enough focus, not enough faith. Distractions will be there. How do you counteract distractions? Not by thinking of distractions. You focus. Yeah, distractions to pehle bhi the, abhi bhi hain, kal bhi honge. Then what do? No, in spite of distractions, I'm not going to talk about them. I'm only going to talk about Ram. By thought, by word, I will be only taking the name of the Lord. Merge into Him. Because you do it every night when you go to sleep. Why is it so difficult to merge your mind into Ram? Why? It's only self-created. This distance between Ram and me is self-created. As long as the mind is, this distance is there. No mind, it's one. In sleep it is one, but you don't know it. You want to make it one when you are awake, when you are fully conscious. देखो, एक क्षण पहले बताया था अचिरात, instantaneously it can. It takes one moment. How much time it takes you? आप मैं इनका नाम भूल गया, क्या नाम है? अच्छा, आप आपको पूछ रहे थे, सुशीला का तो नाम याद है. सुशीला कौन है? मेरी पत्नी बोलेंगे. So when he is thinking of Sushila, immediately husband. If I say Ritesh, in his mind immediately the father will come. How much time it took to shift from husband to father? Instantaneous, isn't it? Then why does it take us so long to shift from individuality to infinity? Even when we are taking the name, there's no distance. There's no distance. It is only imaginary distance.
Split seconds.
It's not. Second is too long, man. Did it take you split second to okay, I understand what you mean. It's instantaneous. Achirat. Dekho. Agar isko atma saath kar liya na. Sare baal khade hote hain. Sochne se hi mere ko. Ekdam thrill passes through you. The thrill on the body is an expression of the thrill in the mind. The thrill in the mind is because it is thinking of the infinite. And we are awake. See. So where are we? So even if we read one or even half of a shloka, one is instantly freed from their sins. Then the second verse, yastu pratyaham adhyatma ramayanam ananya dhihi yatha shakti yed bhaktya sa jivana mukta uchyate. And this also we already did, that if we are focused, you know, those who listen to Adhyatma Ramayana daily with a pure uncorrupt mind, with required, not what you want, with the required focus, with required devotion, with the required effort, then they become liberated from this mundane existence, from this cyclical existence. 31st, 32nd and 33rd verse. Yo bhaktyarchayate dhyatma ramayana matandritaha dine dine swamedhasya फलम तस्य भवेन मुने यदृच्छयापि योध्यात्म रामायण मनादरात् अन्यत श्रुणुयान् मर्त्यः सोपि मुच्येत पातकात् नमस्करोति योध्यात्म रामायण मधुरतः सर्वदेवार्चन फलम सप्राप्नोति न संशयः. नमस्कार होती, विल कम टू दैट. ओ सेज नारदा, यो भक्त्य भक्ति आर्चयते ध्यात्म रामायण मतंद्रितः. ओ नारद, दोज पीपल हु वर्शिप अर्चना अर्चयते अध्यात्म रामायण विद विद डिवोशन. एंड हाउ डू यू व्हाट यू कॉल वर्शिप अध्यात्म रामायण, meaning how do you listen to a satsang in other words, or how do you read Adhyatma Ramayana, how do you do puja of the Adhyatma Ramayana, whether physical or mental, whatever, or how do you take the name of Ram, how do you contemplate on the Atma Ram in the heart, who is your essence. Here he says, do it without laziness, without going to sleep. Only those who are approaching Ram, is contemplating on Ram, doing the puja of Ram, whether external, internal, doesn't matter, it's all step in taking you there, they get the fruit, the reward, the benefit of doing the great Ashwamedha Yajna. Those who do puja, वैसे ले देते हैं, तो maybe first it is puja, which is outside, archana is outside. Those who do archana of Adhyatma Ramayana, or what is that? Those who do puja of Adhyatma Ramayana, they get the fruit of doing the great Ashwamedha Yajna, horse sacrifice. Ashwamedha Yajna was done by whom? Many kings have done it. Dashrath ji did it, our Shantanu did it. Then so many in Bhagavat we saw. Shri Ram ji did it. Yes, when he had the Sita next to him, the golden Sita next to him. Thank you, sir. Mahabharat mein bhi hua tha. Isne kiya tha na? Apne Yudhishthir ne kiya tha. And Krishna was the yajman there, main purusha. Those who listen to Adhyatma Ramayana from others, even irregularly, first part, those who listen to Adhyatma Ramayana even irregularly, and second part is saying, and with contempt or with doubt. Pata nahi kya bol raha hai, par kaan khule hai, par kaan khule hai. I am a Buddhist, I am a Jain, I am a this, I am a Christian, I am a Muslim, but Adhyatma Ramayana kaan pe pad gaya. Are also freed from the effects of sin. Ram naam itna te javadast hai. Then he says in the 33rd verse, namaskaroti yo yah adhyatma ramayanam aduratah sarva deva archana phalam deva archana phalam sa prapnoti na sanshayah. So now the conclusion is told, those who go near Adhyatma Ramayana and bow their heads, this is at a, see, they are slowly going to go inside, they are starting from outside, from the world. So first it was puja and archana of the Adhyatma Ramayana, then it was talked about many people in this world, not necessarily they are devotees of Ram, so they will also benefit from it. And those who go near Adhyatma Ramayana and bow their heads in reverence and do their namaskars to it, get the fruit which is equivalent to all the gods put together. There is no doubt or confusion about it. Na sanshayah. It is a foregone conclusion. This is the greatness of Sanatana Dharma. One in all in one. Remember this. We have no confusion about that. In Ram, all are, and in all, Ram is. And same thing with Shiva. Everyone is, all is in Shiva, and Shiva is in all. Narayana is in all, and all is in Narayana. This is our Sanatana Dharma. Choose what clicks for you. So here he says that even if we go with reverence to Adhyatma Ramayana, it is equivalent to worshipping all gods. And this we have seen in everywhere. See, remember last time I told you, Adhyatma Ramayana begins, the first chapter in the Balkand begins with Ram Hridaya, the secret of who Ram is. I've already mentioned few things, but imagine the whole chapter is on that. And the last chapter in Adhyatma Ramayana is Ram Gita. So from where is the Gita coming? From the heart of Ramayana, of Ram. Continuing. So, see, this is exactly what it is. What does it mean that we bow our heads, that we salute to Adhyatma Ramayana or to Ram? It means we this is our Hindu culture. What is it? It is to surrender our ego, the surrender the I in front of something, in front of anything. Because our consideration is that the whole Jagat is Ramamaya. It is divine. So when we greet someone, we do namaskar, and we don't say, hey, thank you for coming. No, immediately we bend down. We may not bend down. Today, nowadays, children feel shy to bend down. But even if they do that, that is showing that that we are flexible. Our ego is ready to bend down. See? Ready to bend down. Ready to surrender. Ready to see the divine in the other. And in this way, there is no doubt about it. 34th and 35th verse, Likhitva pustike dhyatma ramayanam sheshataha yo dadyad rama bhakte vyaha tasya punya phalam shunu adhiteshu cha vedeshu shastreshu vyakruteshu cha yat phalam durlabhe. Okay. Tatphalam tasya sambhavet. Those who write the whole complete book of Adhyatma Ramayana and give it to another devotee of Ram, those humne kiya hai ye. Adhyatma Ramayana ke saath nahi kiya. When we were in the ashram, once Swamiji had gone to Uganda for lectures. He was addressing the Ugandan what is there? Unki jo parliament hai. To unko bulaya tha. Pata nahi क्या क्या कहाँ का कहाँ क्या चक्कर चला था उस समय. तो हमारे पास 3 दिन थे, 3 days इवेंट. ही सेज उनका ये नहीं कि कर सकते हो, नहीं, 3 days आई एम कमिंग, आई वॉन्ट द एंटायर भगवद गीता. सबको एक एक नोटबुक दिया, कॉपी, राइटिंग कॉपी. सेज आई वॉन्ट एंटायर भगवद गीता with the most beautiful handwriting that you can invoke out of yourself, and I'm going to check every copy. And he flew. And once we started writing, we forgot lunch, we forgot dinner. Once you get involved in it, itna maja aaya, I finished it in 1 day, man. Raat bhar soya hi nahi main. We started in the morning. I must have started. He went in the afternoon. I must have started in the afternoon, went for dinner, but raat bhar baith ke dupair tak khatam, complete. Itna you start enjoying. If sometime you find your mind is not listening to you, instead of doing japa, you take a piece of pen and paper and you start writing Hari Om, or you start writing Ram, and write it neatly, beautifully, every word, not 4 lines laga diye, r a m a line, aise nahi hai, ram nahi hai, ram, beautiful. Everyone should be an expression of the beauty that is inherent within you. Everyone should be the fragrance inside of you must come out in every alphabet that is written on the paper. But dekho, it's like a meditation. And before you know, your mind has become ekdam shant ho jata hai. Phir uske baad jab kar lo. Try karo kabhi. When we were throughout 2 years, we wrote Ram, Ram, Ram. Throughout, every day we used to write 1 or 2 pages. And then one temple was being built. All the copies were sent to that temple in the foundation by all the students. Everyone was free not to write, but we wrote. those who write the complete book of Adhyatma Ramayana and give it to other devotees of Lord Ram, listen to the fruits, rewards or benefits which they get. So, as an exercise, see, until unless you don't do it, you will not know the benefits. And what I'm telling you now, that you write, we wrote the Bhagavad Gita, you try writing it, you will be thrilled. You'll have to go through sleep, you'll have to bypass hunger, but that will only be possible if you are totally involved in writing. और फिर एक बार उसकी लत लग गई ना अंदर से, फिर सब कुछ भूल जाते हो. You will forget to take shower also. You want to finish it nicely because it's giving you इतना सुकून मिल रहा है उसको कर. सुकून meaning क्या बोलेंगे सुकून को? Peace of mind. Tranquility is the correct word. You get so much tranquility. Listen to the, what is it? Adhiteshu cha vedeshu shastreshu vyakruteshu cha yat phalam durlabham loke tat phalam tasya sambhavet. He gets that reward which is difficult to get even by reading and studying the Vedas and preaching, discoursing on the Shastras, scriptures in the world. Dekho, Ram naam se. Sirf Ram naam se. Kya karna hai? What do you have to do? You have to write the entire Adhyatma Ramayana word to word on a notebook and present it to another devotee of the Lord with respect. Not, see, I have written this, I did a great job, man. I did it in one day. I did. No. Do it with devotion. It was not that you wanted to give, you did it to invoke Ram within you. Once it is invoked, then what are you going to do with the object? Offer it to the next one. Maybe it will ignite. Jyot se jyot jalate chalo, prem ki ganga bahate chalo. Hai na? Ye jyot hai ye. This is, jyot means flame. Deep. So with one lamp, you light many lamps. So you share it with others. So it is much, even more great. And it is true. Everyone is not intellectual. We want to be intellectual, but we have not given up our body identification. And till you don't give up body identification, till you do not live a life of non-disturbance in the world, yama, remember, till you do not remain undisturbed by thought, word and deed of some of people in this world, or disturb the people with your thought, word and deed, gyan wo bahut dur hai. You cannot, you're too far away, even though it is the closest thing. I'm not talking about jnana from words. Jnana as tattva. It is so close. Or if we come one step less, understanding the correct way. It is natural. But until unless we are disturbing the world and getting disturbed by the world, we will never be available to that knowledge. And that is why we must continue regularly with satsangs. So this is one satsang. Writing Ramayana, Adhyatma Ramayana is also a satsang. Chanting the name is also another satsang. Meditating on Ram is also another satsang. Doing Manasik Puja of Ram is also another satsang. Parayana of Adhyatma Ramayana is another satsang. All this will be covered now. Abhi pehle puja bataya tha, uske baad presentation of Adhyatma Ramayana book bataya tha. Now they are saying, you write it and present it to another devotee. And that is greater than even studying and preaching. So that was for me. So don't preach. Do. Continuing, 36th and 37th verse. Ekadashi dine dhyatma ramayana muposhitaha yo rama bhakta sadasi vyakaroti narottamaha तस्य पुण्यफलं वक्ष्ये शृणु वैष्णवसत्तमा प्रत्यक्षरं तु गायत्री पुरश्चर्या फलं भवेत्। ओ द बेस्ट अमंग वैष्णवा सेंट्स नारदा, नारद मुनि इज द he is considered by the Vaishnava as the greatest among the Vaishnava saints. That devotee of the Lord Ram, who is regarded as the best among humans, and he who preaches the story of Adhyatma Ramayana in an assembly of faithful people on the Ekadashi day after observing a fast without eating on an empty stomach, after observing religious vows and austerities, shall get the benefit of reciting the Gayatri Mantra with the utterance of every word of this book. So chant along with me, don't only listen, chant, be involved. Sanskrit language, every alphabet, every combination of words, it opens up your nadis, it opens up hidden energies within you. Just like if I say the word Seema, there are so many Seemas, but only here this Seema will listen to me. Here, suppose there are 10 Seemas in this room, all of them will say, which Seema? But if I just add Dinesh's Seema, immediately only one Seema will listen to me, right? It's that simple. So when we chant Sanskrit mantras, each word here, every verse is telling you what the glory of Ramnam, of Adhyatma Ramayana. And don't just hear at this particular moment, it's the book we are talking about. But I'm continuously taking it subjectively also. So he says, he who tasya punya phalam vakshe shunu vaishnava sattama, pratyaksharam tu gayatri purashcharya phalam bhavet. So, shall get the benefit of reciting the Gayatri Mantra with the utterance of every word of this book. When you do Gayatri purashcharana, there is a certain, you have to do so many crores of Gayatri Mantra. What is Gayatri Mantra? Om Bhurbhuvah Svah Tat Savitarvaranyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhyo Yona Prachodayat. This mantra, if you do it for so many times, Gayatri Devi gives you darshan. How many times? Some crores is there. Akhandananji did it. Swami Akhandananji, unhone kiya hai. Jo hum karte hai na, padhte hai sir, Tuesday ko. So he has done the punashcharan. अब उन्होंने वो तो क्लियर लिखते हैं, मैंने शुरू कर दिया कि मैं इतनी बार करूंगा, कितना 14 लाख के 16 लाख कुछ उनको करने दे, उनको किसी सब महात्मा है टोल्ड हिम, तो ही स्टार्टेड, ही डजंट नो वेदर ही कंप्लीटेड इट और नॉट, ही डजंट नो, बट ही वॉज कमिटेड, ही स्टार्टेड, एंड जस्ट आई वॉज टेलिंग यू लाइक यू स्टार्ट राइटिंग एंड यू गेट लॉस्ट इन इट, यू बिकम इट्स अ मेडिटेशन, ही गॉट लॉस्ट इन इट. He forgot everything. He kept doing it. Went away into the jungle and he was doing it, away from his family. And he doesn't know. He writes in his biography, "I don't know if I completed it, but phal mil gaya." तो फल मिला मतलब complete किया ही होगा. Because the idea is, it's not question of how many you do. Question is while you are doing. Have you surrendered? Has the surrender taken place? Has the merging happened? See, that is the art that our scriptures are telling us. हम फालतू में उसको यहाँ से यहाँ से यहाँ से पकड़ने की कोशिश करते हैं, साम नहीं है. See, so then he says, yeah. So how do you do it? On a Ekadashi day, after observing fast, without eating, फिर से क्यों बोला? On an empty stomach, तीन बार बोला है. So that it goes into your head, कि थोड़ा सा, maybe I take a little bit of milk, or I take a little bit of banana for energy. No. Three times he repeats, observing a fast. Like, some people observe fast and they have a big, huge singhade ke aate ke pakode and aloo ki sabji and sabudana khichdi and bhagwan ka naam. Usko to pata hai, wo hai, humko kya lene ki zarurat hai. Badam milk. It's a full smorgasbord of and you are more tamasic after that food. So here he is saying, on Ekadashi day, after observing a fast, and how do you observe a fast? Without eating, he is qualifying. And also, without eating means on an empty stomach. Dusri baar bol raha hai. Aur phir, and stomach, after observing religious vows and austerities, shall get the benefit.
Water allowed.
But not to fill your stomach. Only to keep your throat going. Because you and on empty stomach you are giving and on empty stomach you are doing pravachan. Here it's saying that though he who preaches the story of Adhyatma Ramayana means you are chanting the mantras and you are telling the story. In the whole day you have to remain empty stomach, and not necessarily that the whole thing you finish in one day. Or you can just take a precis of the whole thing, essence of the whole thing, and present it to people. Or you just take some part of it, but you observe that fast, and you are talking. जैसे है हम नवरात्रि में नहीं करते क्या? And when I used to come to Hobart, whole night we used to sit doing Om Namah Shivaya. Where we used to eat or drink? We never used to eat or drink. We used to finish it before 8 o'clock, and after that we used to sit. हवन लगाते थे एंड वी यूज टू चैंट ओम नमः शिवाय ऑल नाइट. 7-8 ऑफ द लेडीज यूज टू कम विद पीटर. नाउ कंटिन्यूइंग, यस, इसके साथ फिर कंप्लीट कर देंगे. छोटा सा ही है बिकॉज इट्स ऑल टेलिंग यू हाउ टू उपवास व्रतम कृत्वा श्री राम नवमी दिने रात्रौ जागरितो ध्यात्म रामायणम अनन्यधीः यः पठेत् शृणुयाद्वापि तस्य पुण्यं वदाम्यहम् कुरुक्षेत्रादि निखिल पुण्यतीर्थेष्वनेकशः आत्मतुल्यं धनं सूर्य ग्रहणे सर्वतो मुखे विप्रेभ्यो व्यासतुल्येभ्यो दत्त्वा यत्फलमश्नुते तत्फलं संभवेत्तस्य सत्यं सत्यं न संशयः योगायते मुदाध्यात्म रामायणमहर्निशम् आज्ञां तस्य प्रतीक्षन्ते देवा इन्द्रपुरो गमाः. Now I shall tell you the auspicious reward got by him who either listens to or reads Adhyatma Ramayana with deep concentration on the Ram Navami day after observing the ritual of fasting and keeping awake during the night. And what is that? The reward is equivalent. And you know who did it this time? Our Hanumanji was doing it. But I don't know if he slept at night or not. But he was doing it during the day. Something he was, I don't know, Tulsi Ramayana or Adhyatma Ramayana, something he was doing. Padmini can tell us afterwards. The reward is equivalent to giving charities to Brahmins who are exalted as sage Vyas of amounts, quantum of wealth, which are same as possessed by the donor. That is, one of half of one's wealth is given as alms at the time of total solar eclipse and at any one of the holy pilgrim sites such as Kurukshetra, etc. There is no doubt or confusion about it. It is the truth. Those persons who sing the hymns of Adhyatma Ramayana with a cheerful mind and intellect, even Indra, the king of gods, and the other gods are eager for his orders. That is, they are eager to fulfill his all his wishes. Why? Because such a person is identifying with the supreme essence. Indra is only one of the expressions, one of the manifestations. Which are the 14 lokas? Out of that one loka Indra is taking suvaha. That's all. Bhur, bhuva, suva, tapaha, janaha, maha, satyam. फिर नीचे तला तला वितला सुतला तला तला एंड द सेवन. तो ओनली द थर्ड लोका इज द इंद्र. उसके बाद तो सत्यलोक वेर ब्रह्मा जी इज, दैट इज ऑल्सो द हायर हेवन. इन यस्टरडेज क्लास आई टो उपनिषद क्लास आई वॉज टेलिंग. सो हियर इट इज टोल्ड कि दैट ऑल दीज मीनिंग वॉट हु आर दीज गॉड्स नाउ टू लाइक वॉट वी वेर टू टॉकिंग अबाउट मग्न, वॉट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एंग्रॉस्ड. सो वॉट इज दिस एंग्रॉसमेंट? इट इज लाइक प्रत्याहार. प्रत्याहार इज वेयर योर सेंसेज आर ओपन बट द माइंड इज नॉट लीकिंग आउट. वेयर इज इंद्र? इंद्र इज टू प्लेसेस. ही इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ द माइंड एंड ही इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ द आर्म्स. सो ही इज द ज्ञान एंड ही इज द कर्म. नाउ यू आर नॉट, वेन ही इज लिस्निंग टू यू मीन्स ही इज नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन डूइंग एनीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड and he is not interested in thinking about anything in the world. Mind is available to Ram. And so also Surya, Chandra, Ashwini Kumar, Dikpa, Maruts, all the gods are in the, this is the microcosm, that is the macrocosm. In the macrocosm, all the nakshatras, all the gods, all the planes of consciousnesses are there. All those planes of consciousnesses are there in this body also. The seven worlds which I told you, Om Bhur Bhuvah Svah Tat Pa Jana Maha Satyam, they are the seven chakras. And what about the below ones? They go from your hip joint to thighs to knees to ankles and below. So seven chakras in the leg. Chakras means the lower worlds. The Asura Lok, they are below. Above the coccyx is the higher worlds. Coccyx is the earthly plane and all others are higher. See? So quickly we'll finish. So basically when you are, our mind is engrossed. Who is the lord of the mind? Indra. When Indra, he is also looking for completion only. Whenever push comes to a shove, Indra runs to Narayana. जब कोई त्रिपुरासुर आता है, कोई जालंधर आता है, ये भागता है. ब्रह्मा जी हेल्प, ही सेज लेट्स गो टू शिवा, शिवा हेल्प, ओके लेट्स ऑल ऑफ अस गो टू लॉर्ड नारायण, फिर जाके कुछ सोल्यूशन मिलता है. अदरवाइज ही इज इगोइस्टिक. नो इंद्रा, ही इज लस्टी फॉर द वर्ल्ड. ही वॉन्ट्स ऑल द ब्यूटिफुल थिंग्स इन द वर्ल्ड. ही वॉन्ट्स ऑल द वेल्थ. इफ एनी वन हैज समथिंग आई वॉन्ट इट. उसको जगह पे उसको, इफ यू फाइट विद दैट फेलो ही विल डिस्ट्रॉय योर लाइफ. You need to show him the right, give him the right direction to the mind, not fight with the mind. Sometimes its punishment is okay, but in general, when we do this, when we have an intellect, we have decided that we are going to do the Adhyatma Ramayana, the mind will automatically get engrossed. When mind gets engrossed, along with Indra, who is the lord of the mind, all other gods also come, because they will listen to their boss. Because where is sun, moon, space, nakshatras, planets, where are they? They are in your mind only. Because just like your mind only is manifesting as the entire dream world, so also in the waking, your mind alone is manifesting as the entire Jagrat Avastha or the waking world. And when your mind is dedicated to the Lord, all the forces, all the potentiality, all the productive potential, all these gods are productive potentials, as Chinmayananji says. All of them follow their boss. Who is their boss? Indra. Indra is available to the seeker who is contemplating on the higher. Because in the end, Indra wants what? He wants also undisturbed happiness. He wants to be nourished. And the best nourishment is not from the ahuti from the world. Best nourishment is when he, Indra, is reminded of his source. And Indra is only for the mind. You are not the mind, remember. When you think you are the mind, then Indra can trouble you. But if you take, you are thinking about Ram, you become the witness, Indra will follow you, along with his whole entourage, along with all the Saptarishis, along with all the Devas and Devatas and saints and sages, everyone. देखो, ये thought मेरे पास पहले कभी नहीं आया, अभी आ जा रहा है. सुंदर. And those persons who sing Adhyatma Ramayana with cheerful mind and intellect, even Indra, the king of gods, are eager to fulfill his orders. And what is your order? We don't want anything from you, Indra. Nothing in this world. Just bless me, bless this mind. This mind. And what, as a seeker, it is our mind. Actually, it is only one mind, but we are imagining that it is one mind. So we say, Indra, please bless this mind that it is dedicated and surrenders to the Paramatma, to Sri Ram. बोलो सियावर रामचंद्र की जय. पूर्णमदा पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम. श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम.